What's up, everybody? Welcome to another edition of The Breakdown. So, in my last video, or not, I wouldn't say my last video, but in my last video that regarded boxing, I had made a video about, and I'm not standing outside DMG and Grant. I know that director kind of makes it look like it, but actually looking at a page. But in my last video, I had made a video in response to 78 Sports about the MGM Grand shutting out the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight, and I'm here to make another video because there was a guy who had commented to let me know of some of the actual real facts of the MGM Grand and how the MGM Grand is going to what their policy is going to be for the Mayweather and Pacquiao fight. So the report, and I'll scroll down, you know, can kind of let you guys read it. That's pretty much all of it right there. So the report, I'm not going to read it word for word because I've already done that, and I'm pretty sure most of you guys out there can read, so you can read it yourself, pause the video, do what you got to do, and read it. But the report by TMZ basically says that, you know, the MGM Grand is blocking out rival hotels from showing the Mayweather and Pacquiao fight. And it basically, this report right here makes it seem like if you're not at the MGM Grand or at one of the rival hotels, you're not going to be able to watch the fight. Which I mean, that's true. But there's also some other, there's also some other parts of this report that's not true. So I'm basically making this video by, and you can read the title, I'm making this video by saying, if you don't have a ticket to the Mayweather Pacquiao fight and you plan on going to Vegas that weekend, you know, to watch the fight, you know, on a TV or something like that, you're better off just staying at home and probably going to Vegas the weekend before or the weekend after if you want to have fun, because everybody goes to Vegas to have fun as well. So what I found out is the guy who commented on my last video, he gave me the phone number to the MGM Grand, and he basically said, you know, call for yourself. And I appreciate him for commenting and you know, getting a few things straight. So what happened is I actually called the MGM Grand myself because I was under the impression that rival hotels would be shut out as they are. But I was under the impression that if you're staying at the MGM or if you're staying at one of their properties that they own, which I've already discussed what properties they own, which they do own some other hotels on the Strip. I was under the impression that if you're staying at one of those hotels, you can probably just rent the fight in your room or basically they were basically going to have the fight on. Basically have the fight on in their casinos, in their bars, you know, in their restaurants or something like that. But that is not the case. When I called in, I did ask a MGM Grand representative over the phone. I asked them, if you're staying at their hotel or one of their properties, would you be able to rent the fight? And she said, no, the guests are not allowed to rent the fight. And then I asked her, would there be some type of closed circuit? Would there be some type of closed circuit deal? Will the fight be shown on TVs around the hotel? And she also said no. So she basically said that they're basically still working out the details on some type of maybe closed circuit or they're working out some details on how they're going to show the fight at the MGM and their properties. But she basically told me at this point, the only way you can watch the fight is if you have a ticket to go to the MGM Grand Arena and watch it live in person. So at this point, people, if you want to be in Vegas, you know, if you don't have any plans on watching the fight, you don't care, go ahead, go to Vegas. I mean, you know, if I had no plans on watching the fight, I'd go. But if you want to go to Vegas and you do not have a ticket to this fight, but you still want to watch it, You better know somebody that stays in Vegas or something, because if you go to Vegas, chances are, or I'm not for sure what the policy is on bars that are around the city of Las Vegas that are off of the strip. I'm not for sure what their policy is. I'm pretty sure they have Buffalo Wild Wings somewhere that they may be able to get it. But chances are, if you go to Vegas and you plan on staying on the strip to watch the fight, you're not going to be able to do it. So my thing is just don't go to Vegas. I mean, a lot of people, I know in 78 Sports, in his video, he was under the impression that everybody was gonna have to pile into the MGM Grand to watch the fight, but that is not the case. They can pile in all they want. They will not see the fight if they do not have a ticket to the fight. So that is what I was told from an MGM Grand representative. If you don't believe me, just call in and ask for yourself, and they will tell you the exact same thing. So I'm just saying it's probably better off if you just stay at home, save your money. You know, if you plan on paying $190 or $100 to watch the fight, it's better to do that than to go get a plane flight, book a hotel, and then you get out there and then you can't even watch the fight on a TV. Because most people are probably not going to be able to afford to buy tickets to this fight. And most of those are reserved for the high rollers and the celebrities anyway. So all I'm saying is that if you plan on going to Vegas and you're watching this video and you plan on being in Vegas for the weekend of that fight, and you, of course, you want to watch the fight on a TV, you better have know somebody that stays in Vegas so you can go to their house and watch it. Because if you're on the strip as I'm speaking to you right now, when I made this video, there are no plans for rival hotels to show the fight, but even the MGM Grand, despite what you're reading right here, there are no plans for the MGM Grand or their properties to show the fight unless you have a ticket. And that's what I was told by an MGM Grand representative over the phone. I'm out. Let me know what y'all think of this.